What is up, everyone? My name is Pamela. This is Spill the Craft. I am so grateful to have you guys here. On my channel, I share all things DIY, as well as hauls and crafts. And if you guys like that kind of content, please do not hesitate to hit that subscribe button, as well as giving this video a big thumbs up. That being said, we are going to do 4 easy yet beautiful Valentine-inspired DIYs for your tier tray. All right, let's get started. Okay, let's start with the easiest of the 4 DIYs. Guys, this is so simple to do and it came out so stinking cute and I'm so excited to show you how I did it. So what you're gonna need is that canvas with the wreath that you can get over at Dollar Tree, as well as some felt, your scissors, and some ribbon, and your hot glue gun. I'm going to take my felt. You're going to want to cut out a heart shape out of your felt. I did have to do this a couple times because my initial heart was a little bit too big. One heart shape cut out in the size that you need it to be. You're gonna go ahead and take your hot glue gun and you're going to put some glue around the edges of the heart and you're just going to flip it back over and place it in the middle of the wreath. After that, you're going to flip over your canvas and you're going to take some ribbon. I am going to use some of this checkered ribbon for the back and you're just going to, again, take your hot glue gun and you're just going to secure the ribbon to the back. There you have it. It's very simple, super easy. It makes a perfect addition for any cheer tray. All right, you guys, on to the next DIY. For the second DIY, what you're gonna need for this one is one of these house picture frames that you can purchase at Dollar Tree. They have 2 different ones. I'm using the longer of the 2. And you're going to go ahead, tape off the frame of the house. You can absolutely paint it. It's totally optional, but I really like that light wood look. I decided to go ahead and take some painter's tape and just tape it off. Once I get all of my edges taped off, I'm gonna go ahead and take my Rust-Oleum chalk paint in linen white, and I'm going to go and give the inside of this frame about 2 to 3 coats of paint. So I just wanted to quickly give you guys a quick tip of the day, and the tip is, instead of waiting for that paint to dry for each layer in between, go ahead and grab a blow dryer, blow dry the paint. This will dry your paint so quickly that this project will, I guarantee, take you no more than 5 minutes to do. Now that the paint is all nice and dry, we're gonna go ahead and remove that painter's tape to reveal those nice crisp edges. Then I'm going to take these rub-on transfer letters that you can get at Dollar Tree over in the crafts aisle. I'm going to go ahead and spell out the word home. And these guys, I was so impressed. This is actually the first time I used these rub-on letters. And I absolutely fell in love with them. They were so simple to use. You literally just, it's kind of like one of those like tattoos. You know how as a kid you put like water and you let the water sit there for a while? Well, with this, you literally just take and place the letters down, rub your fingernail across the plastic and it transfers on to the piece that you're working on. Now I'm going to go ahead and take this heart grapevine that you can find over at Dollar Tree. They do come in a pack of 5, but I just want to let you guys know that you guys do purchase these to make sure that you look at the package really closely, because some of them, they don't look like hearts at all. So just a warning, make sure you look at these grape hearts before you purchase them, because some of them are just triangle shaped, don't look like hearts at all. Okay, so next what you're going to want to do is take these little roses that again are from Dollar Tree. They come in a bunch of different colors. In my Dollar Tree, they only had the pink ones. I only saw the pink ones. You're going to want to go ahead and wrap those little hearts around that grapevine heart. And then I found gluing it down, it was just not securing it that well. So what I decided to do is go ahead and take some twine and tie certain parts off. Once you have all of your flowers wrapped around the heart, you're going to take your heart and you're just going to glue it into your picture frame. And there you go, you guys, there you have it. This actually was probably one of the cutest and probably one of my most favorite out of the 4. What do you guys think? On to DIY numero 3. Now, for this DIY, you're going to need this bamboo cutting board. I took some duct tape, or I'm sorry, not duct tape. I took some painter's tape and I'm just going to tape off, kind of line it up as straight as you can. I'm using this ruler just to kind of help me out. And once I get it nice and straight, I'm going to again take that Rust-Oleum chalk paint again, and I'm going to give this cutting board about 2 to 3 coats of paint. And in between each paint, again, I'm just going to use that blow dryer method. Now that the paint is all nice and dry, I'm just going to remove that painter's tape. It should reveal a nice crisp edge. Then I found this wire twine over in the gardening section at Dollar Tree, and I wanted to go ahead and spell out the word love using this twine. Once I get the word to the way I want it, I'm just going to take some hot glue and I'm just going to glue it down to the board. To remove some of that frayed or some of that the twine little hairs that come with it, all I'm going to do here is take my lighter and just go around the edges. Up next, we're going to take these burlap sacks that you can find over at Dollar Tree that has the heart. They come in a pack of 3, and I'm just going to go ahead and remove the string that comes attached to it, and then I'm going to cut a slit on each end of the bag, and I'm just going to fold it over a couple times. And then gluing them down. Now you're gonna go ahead and take your greenery. I'm gonna again use those mini roses that you can find over at Dollar Tree, and I'm just gonna glue down that burlap sack. Now I'm gonna take this laced ribbon that you can find at Dollar Tree over in their arts and crafts aisle, and I'm gonna make a little bow out of that, and I'm gonna glue the bow down, and then I'm gonna take those transfer letters again. This is completely optional, y'all don't have to do this, but I thought it would be really cute to go ahead and put a number 14 in the little corner of the board. Then I'm gonna take that wire twine again and I'm just gonna wrap it around a pencil, giving it like a little spring look. And I'm going to flip my cutting board around and attaching it with some hot glue. To finish off the look, all I'm gonna do is take some of this burlap ribbon and just cover up the back of that twine. And there you guys have it, this beautiful sign. I absolutely love this one. Y'all have to let me know what you guys think. Okay, we are finally at our last DIY. For our last DIY, We are going to need some paint. I'm going to use some of this Rust-Oleum paint as well as this like neon acrylic pink paint. Purchased this paint over at Ross. They had a pack of 24 neon acrylic paint. And so I think I paid like a total of $8 for 24. I would definitely check out Ross for art supplies because although it's a hit or miss, sometimes they have great supplies. So once you get your paint nice and mixed, you're going to take a mason jar. This is a mason jar I already had at home, but I know for sure Dollar Tree has a mason jar as well. And I'm gonna spray down the mason jar with this solution that I made with vinegar and some water. So that way the paint will stick nicely onto the glass. Now with the Rust-Oleum chalk paint, you absolutely can skip this part. You don't need to spray it down, but I always find it just a little bit better and the paint sticks a little bit better onto the glass if I made sure it was nice and clean. Next, you're gonna go ahead and give the mason jar three nice coats of paint. And then once the paint is nice and dry, then here I decided, well, I kind of wanted to use the lid to open and close. So I decided to take some of this burlap ribbon and cover the lid with that burlap ribbon. But then what I found out was my lid was not closing. So I had to abandon that idea. And instead, I decided to go ahead and take some twine, and I just wrapped the twine all the way around the neck of the jar. Once I glued the twine down, all I did is go back around with my lighter to make sure that all those little hairs from the twine are gone and looks nice and clean. Then I'm gonna take these felt hearts and I'm just going to stick them all throughout the bottom of my mason jar. After I have done that, I'm going to take that checkered ribbon again and I'm going to make a bow out of that and glue the bow down onto my mason jar. I still had some of that wire twine left, so I decided to kind of do the same kind of method that I first did where I wrapped it around pen to make that kind of like that spirally spring look, and I attached it in the inside of the mason jar. Then I just took the rest of my greenery and put it into the mason jar, and there you guys have it. How stinking cute is this turned out? I absolutely adored this entire collection and absolutely would be perfect for any tier tray. Which one of these were your guys' favorite? Please go ahead and leave me a comment down below. And if you guys enjoyed all of these DIYs or this video, please do not forget to give me a big thumbs up, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye!